Now I have something very special for you. Something really special. Something that has kept me awake. A lot of things keep me awake in physics, and not only in physics. But this is very special. This is very special. I have here a basketball. Not completely elastic, but not bad. A tennis ball. Not completely elastic, but not bad. Now I'm going to drop them together, vertically down, and then this ball will bounce up somehow. And so the question that I have for you is, do you think if I drop it from this height, that this tennis ball will sort of come up at most to this height, or do you think it will be lower, or do you think it will be higher? So use your intuition. In the worst case, it can be wrong. He is already pushing his finger off. So what do you think? Will the tennis ball reach about the same height? Who is in favor of that? Who is in favor of higher? Wow. Who is in favor of a lot higher? Okay, I'll try it. Now, I cannot guarantee you that this ball will go straight up after the impact, because clearly that's impossible. That has zero chance, so it'd probably go off at some direction. But you will see the effect that I had in mind. So there we go. And you see that indeed, that tennis ball goes way higher. I'll try it once more to see what I can get it go up a little bit more vertically, but that is very difficult. It goes way higher. And this is something that you should be able to calculate. And you can, and you will. Believe me, it's part of assignment number 6. You haven't seen it yet. There we go. Oh, boy, that was better. Well, oh. Do any one of you know approximately how much higher it goes if this ball has a way higher mass than this one? Of course, the mass ratio comes into it. Any idea? Twice as high? You'll be surprised when you do assignment 6. Much higher. Okay, in fact, you could even see it here already, that it was quite a bit higher than twice. Great experiment, and it's something you can do yourself at your dormitory.